And Meeks back deep. And the breeze blew this one off for DiCarlo. He'll put it back on the tee there at the 35-yard line, and we'll be underway with 2:45 remaining here in the first half. And John will show you how Michigan knocked Ohio State out of that two spot in the BCS rankings today. This will come out on the 20-yard line. For Simmons, DiCarlo, of course, one of the finalists for the Groza Award. And John, what's up now with the LSU team against Mississippi?
Grant, on the Taco Bell update, LSU's defense has been terrific. And here, Matt Mock goes 9 yards to Michael Clayton for the touchdown. 79 yards. That's about all Ole Miss has mustered up on offense. That's why they're down by 3.
And John, you know, Mock's an interesting story. He was in the minor league organization for the Chicago Cubs, and he's a pre-dental student down at LSU. Very bright, very efficient, not going to panic in the teeth of that crowd at Ole Miss today, and that was unfolding the SEC. Here's Simmons.
Watch out.
Oh, picked off, and Poole's got another one. 20, 15, 10, out of bounds. The second interception of the day for Brodney Poole, who was lurking back there playing center field, and he makes it his second pick and the third of the day for the Sooners.
I think B.J. Simmons thought the tight end was going to go in front of the safety. Instead, he stayed right down the hash. When he throws his ball, I think he thinks he's going to go in front of him. See, like a crossing route, and the Poole just beat the tight end to the spot, and that's that miscommunication. High risk, high reward offense here. And if you got a defense that knows how to react to the ball in the air like Oklahoma, you can make mistakes.
Leading 21-10. Poole puts him in excellent scoring position again. From the I formation to the right flat, Runnels cut off, battles, and he's short of the end zone.
Well, that was a nice redirect by Jason White that time, Brent. He wanted to go in the corner of the end zone, and the last second, he threw the ball out to the flat.
Any team that plays Bob Stoops and this Oklahoma team will have its hands full, whether it's Kansas State or Missouri, whether it's USC or LSU or anybody else in the Sugar Bowl, folks. This team is going to be compared with some of the greats of all time. If they get through that Nokia Sugar Bowl, we'll be talking about this team versus some of those great USC teams of the past and Buckeye teams coached by Woody Hayes. The Sooners have called a timeout. And, you know, down here in Lubbock, they've got such great fans down here. And we thought we would pick out this week's super fan, Terry Fuller, graduated in 77. He bought himself an old bus, not just any bus, folks. That's about a half a mil for that one. Hasn't missed a football or a basketball game in a couple of years here. Next stop, he may leave at halftime. He's got to go up to New York because Bob Knight and the Red Raiders are going to the semifinals of the NIT. And there's our super fan of the week, Mr. Fuller over there, sitting in the stands and not too pleased right now. And we get word from the Coliseum, USC 30, UCLA 2, leaving no doubt. Folks, didn't the computers lose credibility this week? Can you imagine one of those rascals had TCU ranked third and another one dropped USC from second behind the Buckeyes after they were so efficient against Arizona? Oh, my. What's wrong with the humans voting for the best teams to play? They like the Sooners. Nothing wrong with that, huh? Second down and goal now. 21-10, OU. From the 2-yard line, Jones the running back. He'll try to power in, and he does just like that.
Really interesting when you have to play Oklahoma. You really can't gamble on offense because they'll eat up a lot of grass with the ball in the air and get you turnovers. But you can't sit back because Oklahoma's offense is scoring points every time they get the ball. You're really in a pickle when you play these guys.
Smiles over there on the sideline. This team is so good they couldn't take a knee against Texas A&M even when they tried. The defense was given an extra touchdown there. And DiCarlo tacks it up. It Gotta be fun to be a Sooner fan right now.
Same play we drew up, this time for a touchdown.
Boomer Sooner indeed. It's 28-10 timeout.
Barry Sanders.
It's like trying to catch a fly and you just can't catch the guy.
A Sports Century world premiere.